6. Holler at your girl, Gogo Michelle. Tell me what y'all been doing this summer. My special guest in the studio today is Next Level Band. That's the music that y'all are listening to right now. What's up, folks?
Good evening, everybody. My name is Daryl Spencer. And,
Father Time.
Better known as Spence. And okay. I initially got involved with this project through some members in the group that asked me to come aboard to help them out because I used to manage Air Raid back in the day.
Uh-huh.
So I have a little knowledge of the management criteria. Mm-hmm. And with my... contacts, you know, I'm thinking that I could help the band out, get them out there, get the exposure, and take them to the next level,
as the
band is called.
Next Level.
We have a very talented group of guys and ladies here, and I have some ideas that I'm trying to implement into the band. We got T-Dog DJ. And we wanted to do some things with a DJ along with the band, per se. You know how the DJs or the rappers are doing the DJ
with
the DJs, and then they have the band behind the DJs. Well, we're trying to do the band and have a DJ behind the band. But it's funny because I have an 18-year-old son, and I tried to let him hear some of the original Go-Go, the earlier Chuck Brown, Razz, and Eve, Trouble Funk, and
that's your
preference, your taste. I said, but when I was coming up through the earlier years, the Go-Go had a music content behind it,
right,
with a little bit of the percussion in the background. It wasn't so much now as the percussion is heavy to the foreground, it's to the forefront, and it's like
throughout the entire play.
So it was like when you had the older bands, the old school bands playing go-go, and you had the percussion breakdown, it was exciting. It was an emphasis.
Yeah.
You know, now it's just, that's when he plays his CDs at home, it's like, can you turn that down, please? It's like, that's all you hear is, you know,
percussion. Have you figured out how to move to it? I still can't figure it out.
I don't even know how
to advance to that.
Get some Grey Goose in, you can move.
But, some of it I like, but it's got to have some music content, some format of music to it. The younger groups, I guess, are finding out that it's hard to get gigs because if they say go-go, it's like... A lot of people don't want to deal with it. You know, they'd rather deal with the R&B or more mature, grown and sexy, you know, type of music. But I guess the most was when we went out to the Capitol Center.
Mm.
We played at the Capitol Center with the Fat Boys. I think it was Kool Moe Dee.
Steph Cesari was there too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that was... You know, for a little band that started out and, you know, grow. Myself coaching, volunteer coaching with the younger kids. Now that my son's going off to college, I have more time to devote to the volunteer work in the community. I look forward to it. I think that's real special to me.
Yeah. Giving back is important. We all have to do that.
Exactly.
Looks good on our resume when we're going up there to Judgment Day.
Exactly, yes. So, like I said, just my volunteer skills come in the form of at the food bank or the homeless shelter. We go and I try to get my son to understand the importance of giving back. So we go to the homeless shelter and serve food sometimes. And like I said, I do my coaching thing with the youth.